Hi and welcome to this week's web design video blog. Today we're going to talk about designing websites using CSS sprites.
Firstly, we're going to explain what CSS sprites are, secondly how they work, and thirdly why they're becoming very popular with web designers.
If you're not already familiar with CSS sprites, you've probably come across the term on blogs, in books, or magazines.
Traditionally, web design elements like navigation bars, icons, and backgrounds are sliced into pieces and then stuck back together using HTML and CSS.
The initial thought process behind this was that the website would load gradually, tricking the eye into thinking the website was loading quickly.
A CSS sprite is one single image that contains a patchwork of some or all of the images that might be shown on a particular page.
Then, using CSS and a little maths, the designer can display a specified part of this image by defining their coordinates.
The best way to show a CSS sprite and to explain how they work is to check out a well-known live example of a CSS sprite in action.
So we're on Apple's website and we're going to look at their very distinctive and respected navigation bar. You can probably see from looking at it, it has several states. There's an off state, a hover state. There's a state which shows you which page of the website you're on. And there's also a fourth state for when you click the navigation like so. So if we take a look at the CSS sprite image for the navigation, you can see that this is just simply one image and it shows all four states of the navigation. Now what CSS Sprites does is it loads this image just once through the style sheet, and then using coordinates you can select a particular part of the image and only show that proportion. So to help me explain this, I've put something together in Illustrator. So I've set that navigation background and then I've just created like this sort of pink mask just to show you how this would work. So for example, using the coordinates you could just pinpoint a particular part of that image to load for all of the states required in your navigation.
Adopting CSS sprites can be a daunting prospect, particularly if you're used to slicing your images and working with them individually.
However, it's important to understand why the CSS sprite technique is being used more and more by professional web designers.
Firstly, there's the fact that you can be a lot more organized, less images and less code.
Secondly, and more importantly, page speed. Combining your icons and images into a single graphic will usually result in an overall smaller file size.
Plus, your website will be making far fewer HTTP requests, having to only load a single image instead of multiple smaller ones.
Smaller file sizes and fewer HTTP requests give you a faster loading website, resulting in a better user experience and happy search engine spiders.
Thanks for watching this week. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them on our supporting blog post or on our YouTube channel.